I can't do anything. Take this exam. Yeah. Okay, I'll take. What? Tell me the example. Yesterday's example. Xt equals to e to the power minus 80 for a. At ut. What is the value of a that we have considered? H of t. Huh? All right. So, see, whenever you see the two signals being given, no, but you won't get the concepts otherwise. Tomorrow I'll ask the same question and you should be able to answer. Those who agree can come. Yeah, what is the convolution formula you tell me? Y of t is, now this is continuous time, right? So you should always remember the continuous time equivalent. What is that? Minus infinity. See, these limits are with respect to which variable you tell? Tau. Okay, always remember that. X of tau. H of t minus tau. D, bolo. Tau. Always remember that. Tomorrow I'll go and I'll be asking the same questions, okay? And you should be able to answer them very precisely. Now see, what is the usual step here? Okay, we know the concept. We have two signals. You take another signal which is H, flip, shift, multiply, add. There are only four steps here. Flip, shift, multiply, add. Let's go by the equation here. What is X of tau? Now see, X of t has been given, so here there is a change in variable, okay, we don't need to worry about that. Tau is simply the acting variable here now. So X of t is e to power minus 80 ut. So as this has been multiplied by u of t, this signal is only right hand side defined, okay, because on the left it is, how is e to the power minus 80, graphically you tell me, something like this, right? But as it has been multiplied by u of t, it will be having only one sided, right? It will start from 0 onwards. Alright. Now, this is the signal that we are having. This is x of t, no? What is h of t? U of t itself. Like, so this is x of t, and this one is h of t, right? So what do we expect here? H of t has to be flipped, shift, multiplied, add. What do we get if we simply flip this? Yes, h of minus, that means u of minus t, right? Like this. Simply flipping, okay? We didn't shifted it yet. Shift is 0 still. So always remember, okay, you should take care of this axis. Always stick to this axis, alright? Now you need to overlap this over this signal, right? So this is what h of, now I will define as in the terms of h of minus tau, no? This is x of tau, just because there is change in variable here. Alright, we derived this equation. Now, what do I need to do? I need to flip, then shift, then multiply and then add, right? So what do I get if I overlap them? So this is the original signal, right? This signal is that, x, you know, this is x of t, no? And flipping that, I am getting this signal. I am simply overlapping that here. Now slowly I am just dragging this from minus infinite to infinite, okay, towards right. Which signal? This h of t. Now I will define that with tau, okay. Now what is happening? Next step, we need to shift them, right? So like this, and we need to look at, we need to multiply them. That means we need to look at the, you know, area, whole app area, right? So as, because 1 into this will be this itself, right? So we need to look at the overlapping area and we need to sum that. That will be the value at this point, tth axis, all right? So you tell me, this is ranging from minus infinite to infinite, okay, tau range. See, when I'm dragging it from minus infinite, there is no overlap. The overlap begins from where? Yeah, from 0 to what point? T onwards. I mean, till T itself, it is going to increase, right? So this we can specify something like this. So it is ranging from 0 to T, right? So this integration is valid from only 0 to T. What is x of tau now? We know that e to the power minus a tau. U of t is 1, so I will simply don't write that. And what is that? H of t minus tau. What is h of t? It's again u of t. That is again 1, so I won't write that. D tau. What is the value here? We calculate. Now it's simple, right? So it is e to the power minus a tau by minus a and 0 to t. How much is this? E to the power minus a t minus 1 by minus a, that is equals to, yeah, 1 minus e to the power minus a t by a. I mean, I have simply flipped. Are you getting what is happening? So I have simply expressed the overlap and whatever. Now this will satisfy. If you try to plot this, now you have calcis with you? You have calcis with you? You try to plot this signal. So 1 minus e to the power minus 80, where a is greater than 0. Let's take it around 0.5 or so, because that will be 0.5 or 1 you can take, no problem. 1 minus, so assume the a to be 1. That's very simple, right? So 1 minus e to the power minus t. You just need to plot that. Plot 1 minus e to the power minus t. So how will you do that? Go to table. 1 minus, what is that? E to the power minus, now variable is x here, no? You need to vary this x. Now see, the overlap is from 0 onwards. So let's start from 0. Let's start till, you know, let's go till 5, say for example, and go in the steps of 0.5. So these are the values that you are getting. Try to plot this. At 0 you are getting 0, at 0.5 you are getting 0.3934, and so on. It is increasing, and see, till 5 it is achieving some value, right? So let's plot for some more values, 0 to let's say 10, at the step of 1, see what you are getting. See, it is tending towards 1, right? Approaching towards 1. So it is something like this. Greater than 0, yeah, 1 you can take it, no problem. So how does it look like? This, no? 1 minus e to the power minus t, so it looks like this. So you should be able to, dekho, ye signals and systems ka 10 mark ka weightage hai, gate examination mein, competitive exams, koi bhi competitive exam le lo, IAS, gate, PSU, if you want to opt for Navratna companies, 8-10 lakh ki starting package dete hai, 9-10 lakhs will be starting packages, Navratna companies. Usme signals and systems rehta hi hai, 10 marks. So can you just quickly plot 1 minus e to the power minus 80? So 1 is what? Constant. E to the power minus 80 is what? Like this. So what is 1 minus of that? Of course valid from 0. I need to take only right hand side. So it will be like this. It will be approaching towards 1. I mean, the amplitude will be 1. Why? Because 1 minus e to the power minus 80 at t equals to infinite. How much is that? 0. So it will be equal to 1. Simple. Alright? Yeah.
Actually, the problem is like I should not explain it that simple way. I mean, I should simply write the equations and leave the understanding for you. Isn't it? That would have been better, no? Increase the pace and understanding, grasping. Alright, so let's take this signal again. Let's take one more example. This continuous time, let's go for discrete time, simple, simplest possible case, see what is happening.
Sir,
yeah. Okay, okay, so that also you want me to solve or you can try it out?
Sir, I...
You tried it. So what is the another example which I have given you? You just tell me how was it. So, let me see if I am having... Yeah, this. So... I think it was this one. And this was having some values from 0 to how much was this? 1, 2, and 3. This was x of t, no? T. What about another signal?
Yeah,
from 0 to 2. Now see, I will just try to plot it graphically. I leave you as an homework to solve it analytically. Okay, you should come up with some equations. So this is from 1, 2, alright. So this is h of, see it's very simple, this concept is very simple, see here.
What is convolution? I will again revise once again. Convolution is nothing but the formula that we have obtained. Convol, this is Latin word, okay, which means, you know, rolling together, that is what it means. Convol, that means rolling together, that is what it means. What do you mean by rolling together? It's Latin word. So in mathematics, it has been expressed with some equation. Okay, so it's like, what is that equation? How do we obtain that? We said that LTI systems were easy to model and analyze, and if When we are getting the LTI system, when we impose some conditions, which were those conditions? Linearity and shift invariance. If we impose those conditions, we derive those equations, right? What was that equation? Convolution. That means any LTI system can be represented with the help of convolution. Alright? So what do you mean by that mathematically? It's like this. We have two signals, that means what? I am having a system being defined by this signal, H. How do we define that? If we give any impulse, I'll get some output, that is what it is, assume that. That means it completely defined the system, at least for one impulse. And this is the input, my voice signal, which I am, suppose this is my call, okay, this is the, and this always my impulse response test here, okay. If I give some impulse, I am getting some output here, like this. And if I need to test what would be my voice output, what I will do, this is my voice signal, assume that. What I will do? I'll simply convolve this signal with the impulse response and I will come to know what my voice would have been in the hall, speaking in the hall. Say for example, my voice is, my natural voice is something, but I don't know what would be my output in this class. What do I need to do? I need to know the impulse response of the hall and of course my voice signal. If I convolve these two, I'll get what would be my voice output in this class. Alright? So, that also we have discussed. Anyone? How practically? So that's why I have given you the homework, because see, you might feel that I am giving some punishment, but that is very useful punishment. You might go to your place and if you work on it, it will be very useful. I won't answer that question. I leave it as a homework for you to find it out how to find impulse response practically. I've given some hint in the previous class. Alright, see what to do. What is the formula? First, you need to know the formula.
Look at the formula very carefully. Or let's see, right now, let's not go analytically in this example. Let's understand the concept. What is the concept? See, what this is the formula, x of tau, h of t minus tau, d tau. There are only four steps here. Take h, flip and flip it. Shift it. Multiply. Point by point. And add. And repeat.
I'll tell. See, this signal is flipped now. देखो ऐसे. इधर का इधर आ जाएगा, इधर का इधर आ जाएगा.
करो flip. Let me erase this.
I need to multiply point by point.
So let's do that. So if you consider this, now after flipping, this is what I am getting, right? This is minus 1, minus 2, and this is at 1, 2, and 3. Is that okay?
Now I didn't shifted it yet.
Okay. So this is what? Left hand side wala? Flipped h na? And this is x of? Yes.
What should I do now? Now there is. Now see the formula carefully.
X of tau into h of t minus tau. See what is happening. This is a function of tau, na, which we have flipped. Tau which I have already flipped. Now we need to shift that. Yeah, for an amount of t, then we need to multiply them together and we need to add them together, integrate them just for continuous time.
Flipping is done. Is there a kind of overlap? So even if you multiply these two signals, they are going to be zero. So this integration doesn't mean anything, that means it will go to zero if you take these integration limits into consideration. I mean till for zero shift it is zero. Integration turns out to be zero. Just because even if you multiply these two numbers, there is no overlap between these two. So x of tau into h of t minus tau is going to be zero. Now we slowly shift. Why to shift? Just because it's a t here now.
Yeah, of course this is function of d tau.
We need to shift it. By what amount? P, right? P now. Assume that now we need to shift it rightward. Just because this is P minus I. Minus tau plus P, right? So that we have discussed by first side. If we shift it,
there will be some kind of overlap. Now always know where the axis starts from. Okay?
Is the h axis called? This one. This is the axis, right? Earlier the signal was like this. After shifting, it has become like this. This is the axis, right? So from here onwards, the signal overlap will start. From there onwards, see, always stick to the axis and look at what point the overlap is being started. So this is 0, no? 0 will start over, right? So from 0 onwards, the overlap will start. Alright?
See here. I'll just draw another picture. Assume that it has, now the signal is here at minus 1. This is what we expect, and this is the overlap area. Is it okay? Minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. This is okay?
It has been shifted by 1 unit towards right. This is what we will get. Flip, okay, shift, okay, multiply. Now we need to multiply. 1, 1, amplitude is 1, so we will get only 1. Now, and we need to integrate. Between what point do you need to integrate? Yeah, so but we need to see this area of overlap will go on increasing. From what point? 0 to? Yes, till 2. So this equation will be from 0 to 2 onwards, but this t is varying, right? So
we'll write like this. Yeah, between 0 to? From 0 to? Yeah, wo hoga, per area of overlap will.
It depends how much overlap,
yeah, that will remain constant.
It is going to increase, then it will remain constant, and then slowly it is going to decrease. Are you getting this? See, it is slowly, no overlap, overlap is increasing. Now, the signal limits are only limited, assume that this is my hand. See, overlap is increasing. Till this point, the overlap is maximum. Alright? After that, overlap is constant. After that, overlap is decreasing and so on. Alright?
So, till what point it would be constant? From 0 to some point. What is that? Till 2, right? Right? Till 2. So, let me make another picture here. I'll come to that. What I'm saying is it will go on increasing till 2. So this we are keeping untouched. This is the point where there will be maximum overlap in two signals. Now this axis T is this one, right? Ye axis tha na, ye wala. Kiska axis? H ka, isn't it? So this one is what point? 2. See? And of course this is 1.
This is okay. The overlap started slowly increasing. Here it is maximum. After certain point here it will be constant. And beyond that point, it will be going on decreasing.
Let me draw that picture again. Let me draw that here. And it will,
it will try to reduce, and when it will be finished, you tell me at what point it will be finished. Like, where is the axis? Note the axis. Where is the axis? Here, no?
Here,
right? Yeah, you tell me. Yes,
equal to 5, right? So at t equal to 5, it will stop. Understood, everyone? Because this is very important. So at t equal to 5, there will be no overlap, and beyond that, it's not meaningful to calculate this integration, right? So have you noticed something?
The starting point, always remember the limits of the two signals. What is the limit of the x of t, x of tau? 0 to 3. What is the limit of h? 0 to 2, initial limits, original, 0 to 2. The overlap limit is starting from again 0 to, it is exceeding, it is limiting till 5. That means the lower limit of x plus lower limit of h will give you lower limit of y. Are you getting? Higher limit of x plus higher limit of h will give you higher limit of y. That is important.
What I am saying is, if x is defined, between limit of x min and limit of x max, or I will write it at x min and x max, and h is defined by h mean and x max. Y is defined between x mean plus h mean to x max h max. All right, are you getting?
Now just note at the overlap, it is slowly increasing from 0, it is going on increasing till the point 2, then it is remaining constant till what, point 3, and then slowly decreasing.
So this is what, this is what we are expecting at the output. The output should go on increasing till what point? 2. It should remain constant and it should then decrease. So this is what we expect as a output, na? Y of t. This is what?
T.
What is this? And tell me its limits. Ye kya rahega aur ye kya rahega? Nahi, tell me the indices. This is very important. This is from 0 to first 5, right? In what point it is constant? Yeah, 2 to 3, right? Of course, they are 4 and 5. Oh, sorry. 4 here and 1. What is, now you should tell me what is the magnitude here and here. Can you prove that? Can you prove that?
So that is what I am saying. Now, this is the graphical way of interpreting the convolution. Flip, shift, multiply and add. Now you need to do the same analytically. We know the equation. Now what do we expect the equation to be here? Straight line. So between 0 to 2, we expect that equation to be t. Because, you know, this. Yeah, slope is 1. After that we expect to be the constant 2. After that minus. Okay. Yeah, I mean shifted version of that.
Yes.
So it's homework for you to calculate this convolution analytically. Okay, tomorrow you should do that. And if you are able to do that, then yeah.
Sir, after that, what do you have to write?
Okay. What we need to write as an answer, you're saying? We need to define equations for all the things. But this is fine.
So in the exam also, equations ke saath saath aapko graph bhi plot karna hai, okay, for better understanding.
Because if you simply write the equations, you may not appreciate this, but if you plot the graph, you will be able to visualize those equations properly.
Yes, I think yours is correct, but you need to plot that properly and you need to verify if it is coming the same. So what he has done is, he has expressed this in terms of u of t. That means, see the original thing, what he has done, let me tell you. He has simply expressed, this was the original signal, right? X of t, no? From 0 to 3. So he has simply expressed this as, can I express this as u of t minus u of t minus 3? No? So batana pad raha hai, dekho. What is u of t? What is u of t minus 3? What if you subtract them? This part will be eliminated, right? You'll get this signal. We subtract these two. So you can always do that, because see, we, it's always beneficial to express like that. But see, yeah, again this is called as you know, realizing this you know boxcar function. This is also called as boxcar function, with the help of unit step function. Okay, this also another way to express this R of t. Now this is what function ramp. No, we are defined like that. It's defined as t. What is ramp function defined? How is ramp function defined? R of t. T for t greater than or equal to 0, like that, right? But what if I need to define this only between 0 to 2? I need to cut that down from here onwards, right? How will you do that? Yeah, but not simply subtract, but you need to shift that also, right? You need to, you know, this has to be subtracted from. So it's a homework for you. You just find it out. What if I need to obtain this line, okay, from 0 to 2 from R of t equal to t? How to express that? No, but it is defined. See, t is for all t greater than or equal to 0. I need to limit that only till point 0 to 2. So what I can do? I can simply multiply t with, I want only till this, no, 0 to 2. How can I generate function which is 1 from 0 to 2? Like this. So u of t minus u of, simple, I'll get this line. How many of you didn't get this? Kin logo samajh mein nahi aaya? Okay, what I'm saying is, this is ramp function which is going, you know, without bound, it is going, right? I need, if I need to limit till 2, what do I need to do? I need to have some, what is called as window, which will only capture this and it will simply discard this. So this is a certain kind of window which is 1 here and 0 otherwise. So if, for example, if you multiply these two signals, the blue one and the yellow one, I'll get the signal like this only till 2, like this. So what is this signal t, the yellow one? What is this signal? Just we have seen how we can break down this into the pieces. U of t minus u of t minus 3 or u of t minus, here we need to limit that till 2. So u of t minus u of t minus 2. If you simply multiply these two, I should get this signal. Alright? Similarly, can you express this?
So there is
yeah, I mean, what I'm saying is this complete signal can be broken down into pieces to express them into elemental signals. U of t is again basic standard signal, elemental signal. T is again very basic standard signal, that we have seen already, right? Basic signals. So we are expressing any what is called as piecewise linear. Now this is very important term, piecewise linear signals in terms of elemental signals. Is that clear? Now I'll just quickly tell you. Now, knowing that, can you quickly calculate convolution of this x of n? Quick, ekdam, padapad. Take any signal, 1, 2, 3. Take that signal, 1, 2, 3. That is also signal. H of n, 4, 5, 6. See, whenever this discrete time signal has been specified, you must ask where is the zeroth axis, because that's what defines where the output will start, yeah, begin from and where will it end from. So what is this? Let me put the arrows here. So can you tell me the limit of output? Quick. Eh? What is the limit of output? Just we have seen. Huh? Huh? How 5? Hey Bhagwan, boli maar do mere ko. What is the lower limit of this? 2? 3, marunga aapko. What is the index? Check the index, not the amplitude. That's why I have deliberately taken this example. 0, 2. What is the index? Maximum index. What is the index output? Output index 0 to देखो फटाफट वैल्यू बोलो इसका क्विक.
Thank you.
Alright, so just a quick view of, see, if you need to verify that in MATLAB, so I'm not insisting you to study this MATLAB, but this is the tool which is very easy to use and know the concepts. See here, there's a function CONV, and which are the signals? 1 2 3 4, na? 1 2 3 4, okay, 1 2 3, comma, another signal 4 space 5 5 space 6, enter. Are you getting these values? 4 13 28 27 18.
Yes sir.
If you are getting that, you are correct. Alright, let's stop here. We'll see more on this in the next class.